Hello everyone, this is Anamika from Galgudiya College of Engineering and Technology. In the previous class, we have seen the Gauss law and electric flux density. In this class, we will see what are the application of Gauss law. Well, in this class, we are basically using Gauss law in order to find electric field and electric flux density. But there is some difference between Coulomb's law and Gauss law. Coulomb's law can be applicable anywhere in any kind of problem, but Gauss law will be applicable only when the symmetry will exist. Gauss law holds for all the cases whether it will be the charge distribution will be symmetrical or not, but application of Gauss law in order to find electric field or electric flux density will be possible only and only when if the charge will be symmetric. Now, these are the four kind of charge distribution where we can apply Gauss law in order to find electric field intensity. The first one is point charge. Second one is infinite line charge. Gauss law tells that total outward flux through a closed surface will be equal to the total charge enclosed. So, in every kind of problem, we need to draw one Gaussian surface. We will discuss that later. Further, Gauss law can be applicable to find electric field due to infinite line charge. It can also be used to find the electric field due to infinite seat of charge and uniformly charged sphere. Once again, we will just quickly review the concept of Gauss law. Gauss law tells that total flux will be equal to total charge enclosed. Here we have used E, which is electric field intensity, and we know that D is equal to epsilon E. As in this formula we have used E in place of D, that is why we have used epsilon naught here in right side. So, Gauss law is always true, but is only useful for certain very simple problem with great symmetry. I already told that in order to use Gauss law to find electric field or electric flux density, symmetry should be there. So, these are the problem solving strategy for Gauss law. The first and foremost step is to select a Gaussian surface with symmetry that matches the charge distribution. Second one is to draw the Gaussian surface so that the electrical field is either constant or zero at all point on the Gaussian surface. Use symmetry to determine the direction of E on the Gaussian surface. Evaluate the surface integral or electric flux. We already told that we have in previous classes we have discussed that surface integral is otherwise known as electric flux. Surface integral can be mathematically expressed as A dot ds over S. Now, this surface integration, which is otherwise known as flux also, this surface integration can be open or closed. If the integration, surface integration will be open, it will give the total flux of vector A through a region ds. Flux of vector A through the region A, through the region S. However, if the surface integral will be closed, it will give total outward flux, total outward flux. Here we were having simple flux. Here total outward flux from a closed surface. Closed surface. See the difference. In open integration, we are getting total flux through the surface. However, in closed integration, we are getting total outward flux from a closed surface. From means closed surface constitutes volume. Means if some surface is there, if this surface will be closed, it will constitute a volume. And if some charge will be placed here, then total flux, total line of force coming outward and cutting this surface will constitute total flux, which will be equal to Q. Okay. So, evaluate the surface integral over the closed surface, which will be the electric flux. Determine the charge inside the Gaussian surface. You need to determine the charge also inside the Gaussian surface and solve for D. Now, as we know that we are having three kind of coordinate system, that is spherical, cylindrical and planar, otherwise known as rectangular or Cartesian. So, in this we will see spatial symmetry, means how to know whether the system is symmetrical or not, charge distribution is symmetrical or not. So, charge density, symmetricity of charge density in case of a spherical will be considered if it depends only on radial distance from central point. As for example, in case of a point charge or a spherical charge, this concept is applied. Further, if the charge density depends on perpendicular distance from line only, then it will have cylindrical symmetry. Means perpendicular distance from line means this kind of symmetry is used in case of line and cylinder only. See, if there will be a line, we can use cylindrical symmetry. In case of cylinder also, we can use a cylindrical symmetry. However, in case of point, we need to use spherical symmetry. In case of sphere also, we need to use spherical symmetry. However, apart from these things, like a plane or for a seat, we need to use planar or rectangular symmetry like this. Okay. So, in all these cases, What should be the Gaussian surface? Obviously, for spherical symmetry, we should consider Gaussian surface as sphere centered at point of symmetry. For cylindrical linear line or cylindrical kind of configuration, we should consider the Gaussian surface as cylinder centered at axis of symmetry. Centered at axis of symmetry, it will be centered at point of symmetry, that is origin. In this case, if there will be any plane or seat, then we should choose Gaussian surface as pill box or cylinder with axis perpendicular to plane. Further, electric field. During calculation of electric field, we need to see whether E is a constant at surface, that is and whether E is parallel to area or not. It can be either parallel or perpendicular. We will see it in example further. Let us calculate the electric field produced by a point charge using Gauss law. Suppose here is a point charge and we need to find electric field at certain point, suppose here or here there is a point charge Q. We need to find the electric field at some point here. Then how to use Gauss law in order to find the electric field? So for that, first step is to choose the Gaussian surface. Second step is see. Let us apply see, this is the point charge Q. We need to find electric field at this point. Then what to do? According to Gauss law, we know that Gauss law is equal to d dot ds is equal to Q enclosed. Okay. First of all, we can find D as well as E also. So D will be outside, here we can write ds is equal to Q, total Q enclosed is Q only. So we will write here Q. Now what will be the ds? We can see simply what will be the ds, surface area of this sphere. Okay, before that let us see how to draw the Gaussian surface. Gaussian surface will be, will consider the point, suppose one charge is kept here Q, and we need to find electric field here. Okay, then the first step is to draw a Gaussian surface on which everywhere electric field will be same, and apart from this, that Gaussian surface should consider this point where we need to find electric field in its circumference. So as our point of interest is here, so we will draw the Gaussian surface like this, such that it will include the point P also. Now this sphere is having radius r. Now according to Gauss law, we know that d dot ds is equal to Q enclosed. Now for this sphere, the surface area will be equal to 4 pi r square. So we will write 4 pi r square in place of ds. So it will be d multiplied by 4 pi r square is equal to q. So d will be equal to q by 4 pi r square. As d, we know that E is equal to d by epsilon. So we can write q by 4 pi epsilon r square. This is the same value which we have obtained using in previous classes using Coulomb's law. I have directly written the value of ds here as 4 pi r square because it was simple and we can visualize that this is the sphere, and for any sphere the surface area is equal to 4 pi r cube. But alternatively you can use ds. We know that in case of for this surface the direction of surface will be ar, because the direction of any surface area is the normal vector perpendicular to it. So the direction of this surface will be towards ar, and in the spherical coordinate we are having three things, r, theta, phi, in order to represent any vector or any point in that coordinate. So r, theta, phi, r has been used in order to find the value of direction. So it has given direction of the area. So rest two things, that is a theta and phi, will be used to find the magnitude. So ds in this case will be equal to, but both the quantity are angle. So before using it in ds, we need to transform it into arc form. So theta will be transformed into arc by multiplying r d theta. However, phi will be converted into arc by multiplying rho. Rho alternatively can be written as r sin theta. So because in cylindrical coordinate in the spherical coordinate this is r, this is a theta, and this value is phi, and this is a rho, this is r. So rho can be written as r sin theta. So here we will write r sin theta d phi. Now the total value, final value of ds will be r square d theta sin theta d phi. If we will integrate this value, then we will get, as for example I am integrating this ds, d dot ds is equal to q enclosed, and we know that q is enclosed is q. So we have written this. Now for in place of ds we will write this value r square sin theta d theta d phi. Now as this is the surface integral, so we need to integrate it in two times, one time for d phi and another time for d theta. And we know that theta is varying from 0 to pi and phi is varying from 0 to 2 pi. So we can write it as d r square will be outside, and here we can write sin theta d theta, theta will be varying from theta will be equal to 0 to pi. Another term will be d phi, and phi is varying from 0 to 2 pi. After simplifying this, we can get the value as d r square integration of sin theta will be equal to cos theta minus cos theta actually. So, minus cos theta, if we will place 0 to pi, it will give some value, and this will give the value 2 pi. Now this will minus cos pi, minus cos pi will be cos pi is minus 1. So cos theta, this will be actually after simplifying this, we will get the value, this will give 2, okay, this will give the value 2, and here is the 2 pi. So completely we will get d 2 multiplied by 2, 4 pi. This r square will come, and finally we will get right side q. So here from in this way also we got the value of q d as q by 4 pi r square. If we need to find e, we can write it as e is equal to q by 4 pi epsilon r square. So both the process are there, you can either one, you can use either one, either you can use the value of ds directly, that is we all know that the area of any sphere is equal to 4 pi r square, so you can use directly, or alternatively you can find the value of ds in this way. Now let us see how to find the how to apply the Gauss law in order to find electric field for a line. Before that, let us see, is Gauss law more fundamental than Coulomb's law? No, only it is the modification of a little bit modification of Coulomb's law. Here we derived Coulomb's law for a point charge from Gauss law in the previous section. One can instead derive Gauss law for a general, even very nasty charge distribution from Coulomb's law. The two law are equivalent, both the laws are same, only second one Gauss law is more easier than the Coulomb's law, because for symmetrical thing we can use it easily and get the value of E easily. Gauss law gives us an easy way to solve a few or very symmetric problem in electrostat. It also gives us great insight into electric field in and on conductor within void inside metal. Now we can use this Gauss law to find, we have seen its application to find electric field due to point charge. Similarly, we can use it in order to find electric field due to line charge also. As for example, if there will be a line charge, suppose this is XYZ plane and one line charge is kept on Z axis then first of all we need to decide the Gaussian surface. We already discussed that for infinite line charge we will take cylindrical Gaussian surface like this. Okay, this is the Gaussian surface. So if we need to find the value of electric field at P, then we will make the Gaussian surface by including the point of interest where we want to find the value of electric field. So this is the Gaussian surface, this is the Gaussian surface. This is the Gaussian surface. Now we know that according to Gauss law, D dot ds is equal to Q enclosed. In this case, if rho s is given, rho l is given, then Q enclosed will be equal to, we know that rho l is equal to Q by total suppose if the length of this cylinder is L, then it will be Q by L, rho L will be equal to Q by L. So, and Q will be equal to rho L multiplied by L. Now, ds, d will be outside, we need to find ds. Ds is which area? Ds is the area, this area, the line d will be in this direction, means we can write d as dy, and the area will also have the direction in this side. Because here we are having dot product, so it will be d ds cos theta. As we know that, we can see from here that the direction of ds is also in y direction, and the direction of electric flux density is also in this direction. So, angle between these two is 0. So, cos theta, the value of theta will be 0, cos theta will be 1. So, the final equation will be d dot ds is equal to Q enclosed will be equal to this one, that is a rho L L. Ds in this case will be surface area, total surface area of the cylinder, which is equal to 2 pi r, if the area of this will be rho, then rho, 2 pi rho multiplied by L. So, directly we can write 2 pi rho multiplied by L, rho L, L. Okay. Now, this L and this L will cancel out, and we can get the value of d as rho L by 2 pi rho, which is the same as we have found using Coulomb's law in previous classes for infinite line conductor. Well, now as this is a electric flux or electric field intensity are the vector quantity, so we should have direction also. So we should have direction also. So let us see, here we have seen that the direction of D is along y direction. So here also we will have A y. As we got the value of electric flux density, so we can easily find the value of electric field intensity also, that is D is equal to epsilon E, and E will be equal to D y E epsilon. So the formula for E will be rho L by 2 pi epsilon rho A y. E will be equal to rho L by 2 pi epsilon rho A y. This is the same as we got the value of electric field with the help of Coulomb's law, but the difference is that here we got all these things very very easily. However, in Coulomb's law we need to derive it in a long way. So this is the benefit of using Gauss law. Gauss law is way simpler than Coulomb's law, that's why we are using it for the symmetrical things, symmetrical configuration. So in today's class we have seen few of application of Gauss law, which is a way simpler than the Coulomb's law. In the next class we will start electric potential, and also we will see electric field due to the dipole. So in next class we will see the dipole moment and electric field at a different position, like on axial point as well as on the bisection of the dipole. So till then, take care, have a nice time, thank you.